Hi, this is Dr. Subhatra. In this session, I am going to describe about the concrete made using waste material. What is a concrete made using waste material means? You are replacing or embedding some of the waste materials that is obtained from the agricultural, urban and industrial waste. It can be either used as a binder material or it may be a replacement material for cement or fine aggregate or coarse aggregate. Some of the types of waste are organic waste, inorganic and industrial waste. Inorganic waste are the urban waste, that is a construction and demolition waste. Some of the organic waste are rice husk, wheat husk, groundnut husk, sawdust and coconut pith. We'll see each and every one in detail. Rice husk ash. It is produced from the rice mill. That is, for approximately, when you grind 1 ton of paddy, you'll get 200 kg of husk. That 200 kg of husk is, when it is left as a waste material, disposal will become a greater problem. It has a bulk density of 100 to 150 kg per cubic. By using this in the construction materials or the manufacture of brick, we can use it in the construction. We can use it in the load bearing walls also. It is more resistant to acid environment. This ash can also be, rice husk ash can also be blended with the ordinary Portland cement, and we can make it as an acid resisting cement. It can increase the compressive strength on a larger scale. The bricks made using this rice husk ash has a compressive strength of 5 to 6 MPa, that is Newton per mm square, with a water absorption of 20%. And then the next waste is the inorganic waste, that is a urban waste, which is mainly particularly obtained from the demolition side. Okay, it may be a broken concrete or broken brick or maybe a crushed glass. Okay, when you are using this material as a replacement one for your along with your old concrete, you can save the cost of construction up to 30%. You can use this material for the foundation, pavements, road pavements, okay, in as a base course or sub base course, and you can save the cost of construction. You can use the broken brick aggregates or the overburnt aggregates, which is left as a waste material, as a lightweight flooring material also. Then coming to industrial waste, first is a blast furnace slag. It is obtained from the, as a byproduct of iron and steel manufacturing plant. It has, it can be used up to 60%. Okay, this blast furnace slag cement contains slag up to 60%. And it has a very less rate of heat evolution. So it is very resistant to chemical attack also. Next is the coal ash. We can also tell it as a fly ash or pulverized fuel ash. It is obtained from the power stations. It's a byproduct. Up to 30% you can go for replacement with this material. Here also the heat evolution is very less and it is resistant to sulfate attack. The major issue is when you go on increase in usage of fly ash, the drying, shrinkage and creep will get increased. That is a major disadvantage there. Then coming to blast furnace slag, it is obtained as a byproduct from iron and steel industry only. Okay. The broken bricks, then red mud aggregate. This is obtained from the alumina manufacturing, the production process of alumina, that is from the bauxite, from the ore bauxite by means of bias process. Okay, this mud, you will call it as a red mud. It has a very good compressive strength, tensile strength and flexural strength. The next one is a silica fume. It is obtained from the ferrosilicon metal production. It is a very good pozzolanic material. You can replace 3 to 4 kg of cement with 1 kg of silica fume. So you'll obtain ultra high strength concrete when you use this silica fume concrete. Okay, silica fume material as an additive material. All these contents I have taken from this reference. Thank you.